Back to Spell Tutorial Services. Today we're going to work with the law of sines. And what we're going to do is solve the triangle that we see here by filling in all of the missing information. Side A, side C, and angle C. And we're going to solve this triangle when given only a side, an angle, and an angle. In this case, we have a side of 40 for B, angle A 43 degrees, angle B 62 degrees. Right, we're going to start by solving for angle C. We know that the interior angles of a triangle add up to 180 degrees. So we have 43 degrees plus 62 degrees plus C is going to equal 180. 43 and 62 is 105. And using the rules of algebra, we see that C comes out to be 75 degrees. All right, so that there is one of our solutions. So let's switch this to red, and we're going to fill this in on our drawing. So we have angle C here at 75 degrees. Now we're going to talk about the law of sines. The law of sines says if you take a side and divide that by the sine of the angle opposite of it, that relationship remains true for the entire triangle. So let's write it out. We have the length C. Don't know what that length is, but I know that its opposite angle is 75 degrees. So I take the sine of that, and that's going to be equal to A, side A, which is unknown. Its opposite angle is sine of 43 degrees, and that's equal to 40, which is side length B, and its opposite angle is sine 62 degrees. So the law of sines says that each one of these fractions or proportions, each one of these fractions or ratios are going to be equivalent. So let's go ahead and first concentrate on this fraction and this fraction. I'm going to set those two equal to each other, creating a proportion. So I'm left with C over C over the sine of 75 is equal to 40 over the sine of 62. And these are all in degrees. When I have a proportion, that means I can cross multiply. So I'm left with C sine of 62 degrees is equal to 40 times the sine of 75 degrees. I'm trying to solve for C, so I'm going to divide both sides by the sine of 62 degrees. All right, in doing so, these cancel out, leaving me with C is equal to this fraction here. And when I put that in the calculator, I find out that C is approximately, that's with the squiggly lines, C is approximately 43.8 units. So we're going to add this up here. 43.8 is equal to C. So now I'm going to go ahead and solve for A. So to solve for A, I'm going to again take what's known, which is 40 sine 62 degrees, set that equal to A over sine 43 degrees. Again, I've got a proportion here, so I can cross multiply. So I'm left with A times sine of 62 degrees is equal to 40 times the sine of 43 degrees. I need to solve for A, so I'm going to divide both sides by the sine of 62 degrees. All right, in doing so, I'm left with A. A is approximately 30.9 units. And let's add this to the drawing. A is equal to 30.9. All right, so here we saw how to use the law of sines to complete a triangle where we're given a side, an angle, and an angle. All right, thanks again for watching another video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please fan us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the name Speller Tutorial.